الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت ذي العزة والجبروت. الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ويو بليف Fear Allah as he should be feared, and die not except on a state of Islam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, bestow upon us the gift to die on a state of Islam. Allahumma ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this ayat from the beginning of Surah Fussilat, telling him to say to the disbelievers, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Say, I'm only a human being like you. يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. It was revealed to me that your God is only one God. فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ وَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ. Then be straight to him. استقيموا, seek the straight path to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and seek his forgiveness, and woe to the disbelievers. In this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching his prophet and the followers of his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a system of belief in which the person or the believer has to seek his balance and his way in it. Because in the beginning of the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the beauty of the Qur'an. And we are welcoming the month of the Qur'an, the month of Ramadan, the month of the forgiveness. How someone will be able to really take advantage of the blessings of Ramadan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, he said to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say these words: I'm only a human being. I'm not a person who has supernatural, you know, powers. I'm not a person who has the power of a jinn or of a ifrit or have the skills of a magician. I am only human being. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned for us the way how they were objecting and how they were, you know, in a way launching all this war and this struggle against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and against the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in the beginning of the ayah, قال Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the Quran, it has the details of everything. Allah made it to be Quran in Arabic language for people to know and given the glad tidings and warning, but most of them they turn away and they don't want to listen. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala detailed in a way to give us, you know, the element of the way of their rejection. وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا فِي أَكِنَّةٍ مِّمَّا تَدْعُونَا إِلَيْهِ وَفِي آذَانِنَا وَقْرٌ. They said our heart are in cover of what from which you are asking us or calling us for. And this is, subhanAllah, is like they have a system of humility from the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam want to distract them, want to delude them, want to lead them astray because they believe that they are on the right path. And this is, they believe, is a wrong belief, of course, because it's a belief that emanate and originate based on their arrogance, bears on looking down to people, on belittling people, and believing that they only have the honor of the truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, continue, قَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا فِي أَكِنَّةٍ مِّمَّا تَدْعُونَا إِلَيْهِ وَفِي آذَانِنَا وَقْرٍ. And we have deafness in our ears like a protection of from your speech. قَالَ وَمِن بَيْنِنَا وَبَيْنِكَ حِجَابًا. Between us, there is a partition, there is a veil, which is like protecting us from you. فَعْمَلْ إِنَّنَا عَمِلُونَ. So work on your own. We have our own work and action. So in a way, leave us alone. And the main two reasons of the disbelievers to talk to the Prophet ﷺ this way one way first to reject his message because he's going to change the whole system. The whole social order is going to be changed. How this prophet or this man calling them for the equality between everyone. So they will not be like slaves, or they will not be like, the slave will be equal to the master in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such a thing they cannot accept. But another big reason is they want to force the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a way to give up from still continue to give them down. Why? Because the words of the Quran is keep shaking their hearts. It keeps shaking their heart to the point they cannot support it anymore. They want to run away from it. They're insisting on their disbelief, but the Quran is really shaking them from inside. And they try to help themselves by insisting and persisting on their disbelief by doing one thing, is to not listen to the Quran. That's why the whole disbeliever, they come together and they have a consensus. What is consensus? How to protect all the people, how to object to the Quran, how to fight the Quran with one thing, do not listen to it. وقال الذين كفروا لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن والغوا فيه لعلكم تغلبون. And the disbelievers say, do not listen to the Quran. Do not listen to the Quran. والغوا فيه, and say words about, distract people, lead them astray, don't help them in a way like, you know, scare them, so do not even give an attentive ear to this Quran, that you may be overcoming them, overcoming the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he said to his Prophet these words, imagine, dear brother, respected sister, this is a way for us, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't provide his Prophet with soldiers from the angels. He didn't provide him with the power or superpowers or miracle. He said, "Say, tell them I'm only a human being like you." It's like, subhanAllah, I don't have nothing except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the situation of every one of us when they are facing difficulties in their life. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. And this is our indeed the condition of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to say next. قَالَ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ. Then be straight to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make the istiqamah, be upright, and ask for forgiveness. Which is mean here, the forgiveness only can be happening if you fulfill the uprightness. Because someone should not delude ourselves. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us to be, you know, for the believer to be forgiven in Ramadan, you're not going to get it by wishes. You're going to have it by uprightness. Therefore, you need to know the condition of uprightness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. You don't want to be in the list of the waiting list, nor of the list of those deprived. You want to be from the foremost, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you. Then you have to understand the meaning of ayatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. Seek uprightness to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take the right course to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, then ask him forgiveness. Therefore, the condition, the first condition or the pillar of the istiqamah, first is at-tabarru' min al-hawli wal-quwwah. I am a human being. I don't have no power. Because la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. How we have to implement it. We have to, like, you know, have personify it in ourselves, to be like part of our system. I do not have any power. I do not have any way to change things except by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. This is the synonym of being a servant of Allah, to fulfill the full servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this ayah, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching his Prophet that by showing his humility to Allah, by showing his servitude to Allah, by fulfilling it into the way of his da'wah, that's how he's going to get the greatest of the reward, as he did sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, when you show the humility to Allah, when you show the servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the first, because this is how you will show your servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is going to be then follow it by patience, by perseverance. And this patience and perseverance, it comes from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How it comes from the book of Allah? Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say words in the Quran, you believe in it. And when you have the certainty in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's how you're going to get the blessing of the patience. So these are the two pillars of the istiqamah, of the uprightness. The two pillars of the istiqamah is first to show full humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. The second one is to have certainty in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which then you're going to be provided by the blessing of the patience. This is the angel. And this is how you're going to find that power, that strength that you can face the difficulties that you one is encountering in his life. This is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah gave him the power, the strength. But then the strength, where it does reside, it resides into the humility to Allah first, and into the certainty that Allah is going to fulfill his promise to you. Allah promised he's going to defend you, he will. It's about you, it's about you. Do you believe in that or not? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that he's going to provide you, he will. Then it's about you. Are you going to believe in that or not? When you believe in that, then you're going to have the blessing of the patience. Because the patience, imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he had to support, or in ways, subhanAllah, to carry the burden, to carry the burden of this hardship, the hardship of the denial of his people, the hardship of the way they mocking him, the hardship of the way they're turning away from him when he knows what he's calling them for the truth. So to endure this hardship, it requires big patience. And this big patience is in which reside the true strength. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for his prophet the power. And this is the true power. The true power comes from your iman. The true power comes from your patience. What are the pillars of this element is la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Then the second is the yaqeen, the certainty in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it to be a clear path, direct you to a clear decision, a clear option. If people, subhanAllah, they want to doubt you of your path, justify for you other path. People, they are telling you this way is better than other ways, or the other way than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have only one option, is to just be upright to Allah. You do not get into argument. You do not get into way of subhanAllah dispute. قَالَ فَاسْتَقِيمُ. Just turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's your way how you're going to find, save yourself. That's the way how you're going to honor yourself. That's the way how you're going to come to the tranquility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you. And we try to understand, if you can, inshaAllah ta'ala, the greater and the deep meaning of such istiqama and uprightness. And it is, you know, it's basics, it's foundation. Is when seeking the reason of a revelation or exploring together the reason of the revelation of this ayat. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah was one of the people of Quraysh, the leader of Quraysh. He said, I am the one who has the more knowledge among you about the sihr, the magic, about the jinn, about the poetry. Just send me to Muhammad and I'm going to try to negotiate with him. So he came to him, they told him, go, maybe, you know, you're going to solve this issue with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when he came to him and he told him, ya Muhammad, innaka qad alamta min as-siti ma bika min as-siti fi ashirati. You know how honored you are, and you know, in our ashira. So you are from, you know, the people, you know, from the family of the tribe of the, you know, of Bani Hashim. وَأَنَّكَ قَدْ أَتَيْتَ وَقَدْ أَتَيْتَ بِأَمْرٍ عَظِيمٍ. And you have brought for us something tremendous. This thing that you have brought divided us. And it makes, subhanAllah, to, you know, to put altered our dreams, to make our dreams to be lies. And you have, but you, by what you have brought us, to make all those who passed away, they are kuffar. There are people who are bad people, talking about your father, your grandfather, and so on. And you are, you know, in a way, showing and belittling our religion, and the religion of your father and your forefather, and the religion, you know, and our gods, and so on. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, In his great etiquette, he was listening. He said, "Did you finish?" He said, "No, listen." He said, "I'm listening." قال وإني سأعرض عليك أمورا لعلك تقبل بعضها. And I'm going to tell you about some things as a solution that you might, you know, accept one of them. قال إن كنت تريد مالا جمعنا لك مالا وجعلناك أكثر مالا. If you're seeking money, if you're seeking wealth, we can collect all the wealth possible and we make you the wealthiest among us. And this, dear brother, respected sister, think about our life today. This is the luring way of the shaitan today. The luring way in this world is about money. Yeah, you can make money, but you can make money by being far from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is still listening. قال وَإِنْ أَرَدْتَ مُلْكَ الْمَلَّكْنَاكَ. And if you want kingdom, we're going to make you be our king. وَإِنْ كَانَ بِكَ شَيْئًا قَالَ رِئِيًا تَرَاهُ فَأَتَيْنَاكَ بِالطِّبِّ لِتَبْرَأَ. And if it was something that you're seeing from the jinn, that it has a spell on you, can bring you medicine to cure you. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال هَلْ فَرَغْتَ. Did you finish? He said yes. قال فاسمع. Then listen to me. قال بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل من الرحمن الرحيم. The beginning of Surah Fussilat. And the ayat that we are talking here. And Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, he was listening in awe, astonished, mesmerized. Then when he came, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to his recitation, قال فإن أعرضوا فأنذرتكم صاعقة مثل صاعقة عاد وثمود. If they turn away, then I warn you. It's a blast like the blast that has been inflicted on the people of Thamud and people of Aad. He was sitting in jammed and he covered the face, the mouth of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, told him stop. Told him stop. أنشدك بالله والرحم. I begging you with Allah and the kinship we have between us. Stop. And he left. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't have anything. Didn't have anything that we, he had everything, but according to the criteria or the people how they think, he didn't have power. He didn't have army. He didn't have soldiers. He didn't have weapons. He didn't have money. He didn't have wealth. He has only the words of Allah. Only the words of Allah. He has a ubudiyyah. He had the servitude. He had the humility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He had the true istiqam. He had the true istiqam. He had the whole power because he had the words of Allah. He had the yaqeen. When you read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's what you need. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you, I'm going to help you, then he's going to help you. What you need sabr. Just be patient. Because if you cannot be patient, then we have a problem. You have defect in the foundation. What is the defect in the foundation? You don't truly believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise. You don't. Then if these are the pillars of the uprightness who help you to be forgiven, remember, فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. If you're truly finding, seeking the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be honored by the forgiveness is just committing, it's not just committing a sin and coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. No, the forgiveness is an elevation. Allah elevate you. The forgiveness is a purification. The forgiveness is an honoring. The forgiveness is coming nearer and nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the meaning of the forgiveness. You ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you didn't have any done your day, any single sin, if you believe that you didn't do it. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he kept asking forgiveness every day, and in one attending or gathering, he will have done it maybe more than 70 times to 100 times. So the forgiveness required the istiqamah. You will not be able to taste the meaning of the forgiveness if you do not have the uprightness. And the uprightness, these are the pillars of the uprightness. But what is the madkhal? What is the entrance to the uprightness? How can we open the door to this uprightness? Dear brother, respected sister, is to taste the Quran. Taste the word of Allah. To find the flavor of the words of Allah. That's the entrance. Because if you do not have connection with the book of Allah, and we were talking about this as the way how welcoming Ramadan to make your objective. The first entrance to the istiqamah, which is going to help you later on to ask sincerely, truly, with the determination for the forgiveness, inshallah, in Laylatul Qadr. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us reach Laylatul Qadr after making us reach Ramadan. That you have that sincerity and determination, because you know that you have worked for it. You took the right steps, inshallah ta'ala. So the entrance for that istiqamah is to taste the Qur'an. There is many of the companions, they accepted Islam by listening Qur'an. At-Tufayl ibn Amr al-Dusi, when he came to Mecca, the people of Quraysh, they have their campaign. Whether they campaign any new, especially in the season of the Hajj, and the Prophet ﷺ was making his da'wah, they were warning about the ulam of Quraysh. This is crazy, this insane, he's talking words like of magic, so be careful. So At-Tufayl ibn Amr al-Dusi said, subhanallah, this is a scary thing. They really scared me. He's even, subhanallah, he blocked his ear with cotton. He put cotton in his ears so he would not listen to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, قال شاء الله سبحانه وتعالى, I was standing and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was close to him, standing praying in Al-Masjid Al-Haram. And he heard a little bit of the Quran, little bit of this magic. He didn't comprehend it well. And he said to himself, قال إني شاعر لبيب, I'm a smart, you know, a poet. So if his really words are good, I will accept it. You know, why these people are scaring me? You know, I should trust my opinion. Then he followed the Prophet ﷺ and he told about those people what they told him. And he said, I want to listen to you. When the Prophet ﷺ recited to him the Quran, he accepted Islam right there. Right there. Another amazing story is the story of Jubayr ibn Mut'im. Jubayr ibn Mut'im. Jubayr ibn Mut'im is the son of Mut'im ibn Adi. And Mut'im ibn Adi, he the one who have accepted the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to enter in his protection when he was, subhanAllah, in Al-Ta'if and he could not come back to Mecca. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, if it was Mut'im ibn Adi alive and he asked me about the captives of Badr, I would have gave him to him. So they send his son to negotiate with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم because they know the place of Mut'im of Adi in the sight of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Jubayr ibn Mut'im came to Medina. When he came, the Prophet ﷺ was leading Salat al-Maghrib. And he heard this ayat. He heard, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَلْ لَا يُقِنُونَ. Were they created from nothing? Who or are they the creator? Or have they created the heaven and the earth? But indeed, they do not believe. Wallahi, dear brother, respected sister, this two ayah is the answer to the all philosopher of the metaphysics. Is subhanAllah a proof that we leave them with no words to say? Were they created from nothing? Or they are the creator? Or have they created the heaven and the earth? But indeed, you don't believe. Jubayr ibn Mut'im said, when I have heard this ayat, Wallahi, said, it shook my heart. I felt like my heart can be ripped apart from my chest. And he said, that's when Iman get into my heart. That's when I accepted Islam. That's when I understood what this brother, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what he's saying are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ask yourself, how much the Quran has an effect in you? Or are we reading the Quran like words, calculating the reward by letter? Or you're reading the Quran because it is the Quran? Or you're reading the Quran, just open it to kiss it and put it back on the shelf? Or you must read the Quran the way of Tufayl, he read it, and Jubayr, and also Umar ibn al-Khattab. The amazing story of Umar ibn al-Khattab, when he was left his home and he has his sword with one goal to kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was close to Dar al-Arqam ibn Abi al-Arqam, and one of the companions, he didn't know that he's Muslim, said, where are you heading? He said, I'm heading to the Prophet, to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to kill him. And he was scared, this companion. He said, if you want to think, first think about your family. Your sister accepted Islam. He heard his sister, he ran to his sister and her husband is Sa'id ibn Zayd, and their teacher was Khabbab ibn al-Arat. He saw them, he find them, and he did what he did to not, you know, get you all the details. We go to the most important part. After, you know, he hit his sister and everything, he said, okay, let me read what I have heard you reciting. She said, Fatima, his sister, she said, no, you should clean yourself first. You have to wash. Subhanallah, the amazing things that Umar accepted to be to wash. Because the Quran has such a magic, the beautiful magic, the positive magic. That's few words that he didn't read, that he didn't hear clearly, that really had him to have the curiosity even to submit to the order of his sister to wash, to read the Quran. And she gave him one sahifa, it has the beginning of Surah Taha. Taha, ma anzalna alayka al-Qur'an litashqa tanzeelan, a revelation sent down by the one who created the earth and the highest heaven. الرحمن على العرش استوى له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى. This Rahman, the most merciful, he's not the one who's wrath, the one who's angry, he is the most merciful. He has the dominion of the heaven, the earth, what would between them and whatever under the ground. And Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه reading this ayat, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to read the Quran like Umar even before Islam. He was contemplating, thinking, and his mind is going all around this creation. This belongs to Allah. This belongs to Allah. What under my feet belongs to Allah. What between this earth and the heaven belongs to Allah. I belong to Allah. Umar belongs to Allah. Umar is a creation of Allah. Umar is a servant of Allah, is a slave of Allah. Umar, he is under the grasp of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how we need to read the Quran. It does not require deep knowledge. It does not require, you know, years of knowledge to understand the tafsir. It requires just a taste, to taste the Quran. How many people, they read novels and they are subhanAllah, they do not stop crying. How many people they read words or articles, they will have their heart twisted the rest of the day. How many people they watch movies, like subhanAllah, they will be thinking about this movie like days after. And you do read the Quran and you close the book of Allah and you do not have anything that move you inside, that we are then far from the istiqamah. That's what Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, where's Muhammad? I need to see him. Said, for what reason? To accept Islam. A man who left his home to kill Muhammad, now he's seeking Muhammad to accept Islam. The entrance to the uprightness, who help us to get the forgiveness, is to taste the Quran. Read it as you read a novel. Read it as you watch a movie. Read it as you play a game. Your heart in a game, you want to win and everything. Try to read the Quran that way. It's very simple. Just shift. Shift those emotions. Shift that attention. Instead to have it for dunya thing, have it just please for only 5 minutes for the Quran. You change your life. That's why, subhanAllah, we need to prepare ourselves. This entrance for the istiqamah, who's going to help you protect the foundation of your deen. Protect your identity as a Muslim. They will not impose on you an identity or impose on you things that are sane in Islam, that are beautiful in Islam, now with the new system thereby seen as ugly thing. There's many things people they cannot do. Why? Because, oh, people they might think that we are like things. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put it in his book. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, praise it in his sunnah. What are you running away from it? Why? Because people they see it according to their criteria, like so and so things. No, you have to defend such values to not subhanAllah disappear from our tradition, from our etiquette as followers of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is what Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu did. is what the Prophet ﷺ asking us to make dua, is to make the Quran the spring of our heart, the life of our heart. Is a dua that we make. After inquiring and invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with every name that He has, said, "Oh Allah, make the Quran to be the spring of our heart." Why the spring? The spring that is green, like subhanAllah, the greenery. Where things grow, so things, blessing will grow into your system. Tranquility will grow into your system. Strength will grow into your system. And then everything from anxiety, from sadness, from grief, is going to be, subhanAllah, evacuated from your system. That's why the Prophet ﷺ قال اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا and the نور ونور أبصارنا and the light of our sight, of our inner sight. وذهاب غمومنا and the removal of our anxiety, of our depression, of our grief, of our sorrow is only through the way of the Quran. فمي الله سبحانه وتعالى to make the Quran ربيع قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وذهاب غمومنا وجلاء أحزاننا وقائدنا إلى جنات النعيم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. If there is one surah that we'll start with to taste the beauty of the Quran, Surah Al-Sharh. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing to His Prophet to praise Him, to honor Him, to lift Him in a very high place. Said, have you not lifted your heart? قال ورفعنا عنك وزرك and removed the load that you have, the load of problem, the load of hardship. The one that he's really anqadha dharak. It was like breaking your back. This is when you follow the Prophet ﷺ, every believer has part of this ayat. Because when you taste the Quran, you're going to have an intro into your relation between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask yourself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sharaha laka sadrak. He didn't expand your chest. He didn't uplift your heart by having you to accept Islam. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى ومن يرد الله أن يهديه يشرح صدره للإسلام. The one that Allah سبحانه وتعالى wants to guide, He expands, He uplifts His heart with Islam. أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه. So when you read this ayat, it addresses to the Prophet ﷺ that you have a part of it because you are a follower of the Prophet, because you are a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال ألم نشرح. Read this ayat as preparing for your Ramadan. You're going to say, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gifted me with the sharh of the sadr. And yet, we are, subhanallah, having loading ourselves with such an anxiety that really does not exist. Its foundation, it's had in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to solve it. And we are trying to face all this problem on our own, which is going to add more sorrow to ourselves. It's killing us from inside. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala, alam nashrah laka sadrak. Why are you like this? Why are you enduring these difficulties like the end of this world? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already sharah laka sadrak. ورفع لك وزرك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we're talking about the tafsir, that Allah removed all this hardship that you have, and the wizard from the society that we live in. The wizard that they name your names and they are not yours. The wizard that there is a tradition that they are imposing on you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you to free yourself from it. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was facing difficulties because of the tradition he used to live. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do not disregard their tradition, disregard their way. So to help yourself, liberate yourself from the tradition, from the ill tradition of the society, from the ill pressure of the society to liberate yourself. When you liberate yourself, then you can breathe. When you can breathe, then you have a clear mind how to face the hardship. الذي أنقذ ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك, and we raise your name. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, for every believer, when you stand in the night, sincere, devoted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call Jibreel and said, yeah, Jibreel, I love so-and-so, it might be one of you. And he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jibreel will call into the heavens and said, Allah loves so-and-so, then love him. Can you imagine? You are very famous in the heaven if you are close to Allah, if you are follow the istiqamah as it should be. And that's why one of the great scholars said, قَالَ الْكَرَامَةُ. What is the best of the karama? The karama is not to have miracle. The karama is to be istiqamah, لزوم الاستقامه, to be perseverant of the istiqamah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the gift of perseverance of the istiqamah, and before it, the entrance to the istiqamah, to have the ability to ask sincerely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the forgiveness. Ramadan is coming to you, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Allah has obligated on you its fasting. In it, the gates of paradise will be open, and the gates of hellfire will be locked. The shayateen, the athareed, they will be locked to help you find the istikhara. In it, a night better than 1,000 of night. Whoever who's deprived from it, he's really the mahroom. The Prophet ﷺ said, Amin, in the minbar, when they asked him about one of the Amin, he said, whoever who reach Ramadan and he come out of Ramadan without being forgiven, he eat the mahroom. Do not be mahroom. Please do not be mahroom. This is an opportunity for you to honor yourself. So seek the istiqamah after showing humility and servitude to Allah, and believe in what Allah promised you. Believe that where is your strength? You don't need money. You don't need power. You don't need anybody. Just to believe. Have certainty in what Allah is telling you. He said, I'm going to help you. He's going to help you. He said, I'm going to provide you. He's going to provide you. He's going to give you rizq. He's going to give you rizq. Just be patient. That's where is your strength. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to reach Ramadan, to get to the istiqamah, and to be forgiven. Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. Allahumma aj'alna min al-mustaqimeen ya arhamar rahimeen. Allahumma arzuqna al-istiqamata abadan ma ahyaytana. اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصابرين، اجعلنا من عبادك القانتين. اللهم لك أسلمنا وبك آمنا وعليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا، فاغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.